environment in itself of change. It was not just touching women. Gender became the cross-cutting. It's a very cost-effective model because the CNAs were volunteer, and it's a replicable model with the money. She's a CNA. She's here as well also. Okay, just some comparisons, as I said, that we did the baseline and the end line. So just to show you, to make it evidence-based, that it does work. The source of nutrition information, although the Anganwadi and ICTs remained high, but even then, the CNAs were higher than even both combined, the Anganwadi workers and the ASHA workers. The breastfeeding behaviors had improved a lot during the end-line survey related to the baseline. The diarrhea, which has remained a cause of death for very long among children, if we see children who were given more to drink has increased from the first line from 7.1 to 42%. And also the use of diarrhea from 34 to 84%. This is used as when the child was actually ill with diarrhea. So the usage has gone up from 34 to 84%. So that has brought a lot of change because of the knowledge that was built around these aspects. Importantly, the food security has improved a lot. If we see child food secured, in the baseline we had 23.33% children who were food secured, and a higher number, 76%, who were not food secure. But if we see in the end line, 52% are secure and 47% are insecure. So the kitchen gardening actually also brought food security, because when you talk to a lot of women, they say that because now we have vegetables growing in our own garden, we are eating more of vegetables, we are eating more quantity also. Because earlier when we had to buy, we would only buy sometimes, but now that it is there. Also the quality has increased because everybody gets enough quantity to eat. So the food security has in general, also for women, it has increased to 53%. This is the dietary diversity, which has also increased. If you will see the green leafy vegetable, that is increased from 13 to 57.7% has increased. Because in the gardens, they are all growing spinach and several other green vegetables. And also the other vegetables have increased from 33 to 84.6%. The milk products and roots and tubers have also increased. Lentils have increased. The coping strategies. As I mentioned, that the whole project was actually around nutrition and household food security. So initially in baseline, about 91% said they borrowed food, but in end line about 54%. There were 22% people who said that during the leaner months they would skip the food for the entire day. So we can see the extent of hunger in the area, which reduced to 12%. And if you see the reduced number of meals per day from 35 to 27%. Borrowed food from friends had again reduced drastically from 91 to 54%. Saving behaviors has increased, and it has increased to 52%. And the savings have also made the people, the community, access health services, which is very important. Because earlier a lot of the community members would not go because they did not have enough money. But the savings have access, I mean, we have got it in our end-line survey, although that slide is not here. But the access to the health services has increased as well. So that is what. So this is just very in brief that I wanted to take you through the project. And because we have the partners here, implemented the project, and we also have the CNAs. So you will have a lot of ample opportunity to talk to the partners and ask them several other questions. I just wanted to take you through the project very briefly, just to give you an idea of what the project was like. Thank you very much.